saying here is that ultimately, we may be completely free of any outside assistance whatsoever. And that's obviously not very good news, because we're reliant then almost wholly on property taxes to fund our local budgets and don't have any form of outside assistance. And property taxes is a regressive tax. The benefit of having state aid and share revenue is that's based on sales and income taxes that's shooted at the communities. And those are more progressive forms of taxation. So we will be, we're moving very closely to being 100% reliant on local, revenue. And what are local revenues? As I mentioned, town park receipts, that includes real estate transfer tax. That's the biggest ticket item within that $300,000 revenue expectation. But it's also probate fees, licensing fees, et cetera. Building inspection fees, we actually were fairly steady. They drop off from $175,000 in 2009, but we never did actually realize that number. That's when the economy started to slide. That was a budget number, not an audited number. And this year, last year and this year, we expect to be a little steady at 150,000. Building numbers are about overall new construction projects is falling from an average of 24 or so per year down to about 12 or 14. Renovations, tear downs, and so forth, federal attached to, have not really significantly at all. And we have some very large projects that we see drive around 9 that are still under construction. Recreation receipts is a very large revenue source as well. We saw $450,000 in revenue in 809. We increased some of the fees, particularly at Fort Getty, in the current year budget to raise our revenue investment to $475,000, and that's over the target. And we're projecting another $15,000 increase to $490,000 for next year. Parking to daily parking and overnight parking. And, dog fines, actually that's a misnomer. It's not just dog fines, it's the licenses for dogs. Most of the revenue comes in from dog licenses, not from fines. Finance department revenue is $80,000. Golf course, we get $150,000. We get more than $150,000 revenue from golf course at least every year. We use $150,000 for the town, overall town budget. GEMS through its ambulance service that generates, we budget $100,000, but that's a, Leonard Nielsen and Mandeville also attest to. That's a number that we're striving to reach based upon the amount of billing we can successfully achieve with the advanced force set of agents for hospitals, South County Hospital. Generally more than $30,000. Transportation for user fees, we budget $90,000. That's been a pretty good number. After we raised the raise to $100 a year or so ago. Fire police alarms, another $8,000. Rental Turnpike and Bridge Authority, we get $25,000. They give us in-kind money now. We get them receipts for public safety equipment, either police cruiser, fire department, or GEMS equipment upgrades. And they will pay us up to $25,000 in total receipts for the monies that we spent. That's a part of that number. Interest on like tax payments is $100,000. Investment income. See, in 08-09, we budgeted $175,000. That's money that Tina, our finance director, is able to generate by investing short and midterm cash, our unlisted fund balance. As well as our tax revenue prior to their expenditure to generate interest income. That was $175,000 in 08-09. We're projecting $75,000 in fiscal 10-11. That's just the fact that interest rates are below 1%, whereas previously they were upwards close to 4%. This local trust is giving us a dividend on our insurance of $15,000. Overall, we have about 1.58 million in local revenue. That's down from 1.7 million in fiscal 2009, largely due to interest income and land transfer, which had declined somewhat. The state, despite the fact that they are moving all sorts of revenue support, still maintains regulatory control over the cities and towns with respect to the amount of the level at which we can raise property taxes year to year. It's Senate Law 3050, when you fact, 3 years ago, and again, 5.25% was our tax levy cap, and now the tax levy that we propose on the community of Hawaii, increased year-to-year, and it's falling by 0.25% per year. Eventually, we'll reach 4% 3 years, actually, fiscal 13. Fiscal 11, the cap is 4.5%. No community can increase their property tax levy more than 4.5% unless they use certain conditions. One of them is loss of state aid. Obviously, with the bigger communities losing substantial amounts of state aid, they can go to the general, the auditor general, and say, look, I lost 5% of my state, my revenues that were from state that I need to support my budget. How can I possibly stay within the 4.5% just to support what I have now? So there are overrides to that. Jamestown, we have never overridden that, nor do we, for showing a second, where do we intend to. Based upon the 4.5% levy limit for next year, we could raise $769,177 more over our revenues this year, our proposed property, real property tax increase is $200,818. That's a 1.18% property tax levy increase. So absent the loss of the motor vehicle revenue, that's what we're saying we need in real property tax increase in order to support the proposed budget, well under 4.5%. The motor vehicle tax, that started in 1998, so it's been in existence for 10 to 12 years. Started as a means of phasing out the tax on vehicles altogether. The state was, because of other priorities and other financial problems, really was never able to get that program jump started or on pace with what they originally intended. So obviously, they intended to wipe it out altogether. They were only able to decrease the exemption. That's the first $1,500 value, which began in fiscal year 2000 to $6,000 value in the current year. That $6,000 value means that every car in Jamestown, you don't pay up to the first $6,000 value. After that, you pay $14.42 per thousand. That first $6,000 value represents $440,000. The state is saying, don't tax that, but we'll collect income and sales taxes or progressive sources of revenue, and we'll return that money to you as a form of property tax that we give local residents. Because of the $200+ million deficit the state is facing this year, and we expect $500 million deficit next year, this program, which costs the state $135 million to return reimbursable motor vehicle tax to this account, is being eliminated in its entirety. You see, it's going to work out in Jamestown. The province is 23 million. So we have a whole different order of magnitude problem than the city of province. My budget, presenting for the account council and the taxpayers, assumes that we're going to tax on the full value of the cars. I don't see how it's going to absorb $440,000 in lost revenue from the state and still support a reasonable budget. So I'm assuming that we're going to tax the first dollar of value reach the car. And $6,000 of value for any car that's worth $6,000 or more now, that will mean tax of $6.52 next year that you didn't pay this year. Just by way of example, when that program started, the tax rates that were in effect on cars on each of the communities at that time, was a tax rate that was frozen from that point forward. So we've been taxing cars at 1442 since 1998. That's one of the lower tax rates in the state. Most of the suburban communities generally tend to be in that $20 to $24 per car or per $1,000 assessed valuation. So for them to reimpose this tax, obviously, is more money per car that they would need to bill in order to get the full value of the lost revenue from the state. Providence, their car tax rate is almost $78 per thousand. And so in order to tax, recapture the full value of the tax that the, or the reimbursement that the state is taking back, they would need to tax each car $450 per car.